Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'll be showing you how to make your own SATC or for sure slider exciter Tesla coil. First we have to build a coil, and for that you can use a PVC pipe or better a glass tube like this one I have here. The glass tube has a height of around 27 cm and the outsider of around 6 cm. Now because the base of the tube is a bit wider, I will be winding my wire just on an area of around 25 cm. For winding the secondary coil, I will be using some 0.2 mm emailed wire or so called magnet wire. And for making the job easily, I will be securing the spool of the wire using two small spools of the solder wire and some small tweezer and a metal tube. Now like that it will be much better, cause now I can wind the secondary wire around the Tesla coil much faster. Now when you are making the secondary of the Tesla coil, try to make the winding uniform as possible without overlapping the wire, because if you are overlapping the wire, that section of the secondary coil it will not be working. And believe me, you will overlap the wire, but with a steady hand and a lot of patience, you will be making it. So here is my secondary coil, finish it. This took me around 1 hour and a half to wind, and the total of the winding number is around 1250 turns. After finishing, I recommend you to give an extra layer of isolation. This can be achieved using some scotch tape, which you have maybe lying around, or if you have, use some cut off tape. I done a mistake, just wait for it. The secondary coil is ready to be tested, but first I have to make a base for it, and for that I will be using some piece of plexiglass which I have lying around from a previous project. With the help of a Dremel, I have shown you how to make it in a previous video, by the way the link can be found in the video description, and as well a hole saw, the two pieces they are done. Now I am sanding mine to make them a bit uniform, because it seems I did a bad job when I was cutting it with the saw, but this it will be easy fix using a lot of sandpaper and a lot of patience. Now after the coil is mounted, we can start making the primary coil of the Tesla coil. For making the primary coil, I will be using some 1.25 mm emailed wire, and after giving it 2 turns of wire, the Tesla coil is done. Keep in mind that my Tesla coil is not having a top load. Now it's time to test it, and for that I have designed this first circuit, but now it's coming that mistake I have told you a few minutes ago. When I was nearly ready to test the Tesla coil, I was a bit excited. So I didn't cover the secondary coil with some extra layers, so I have learned the lesson. Now the fun part begins. I have to rewind again my secondary, but I don't have any more emailed wire of the same diameter. So after cutting it, the remnants of the wire left on the coil, I grab some black emailed wire, this time with a diameter of around 0.4 mm. Now this increase of the thickness of the wire in the secondary coil, it will reduce the final number in half. So instead of around 1250, it will be getting a coil with around 625 turns. And after making again the coil, this time a bit faster because of the thicker wire, I was ready in less than an hour. So now after finishing the Tesla coil, we can test it. And for that I have made this simple circuit. This is a simple SATC or for short simple slider exciter Tesla coil. This circuit is very simple and simple to replicate if needed, so give it a try. Now let's explain the operation behind the circuit operation. A slider exciter Tesla coil in a circuit, it will tune the primary coil to match the secondary resonance frequency, and it is the simplest circuit so far to test a Tesla coil, which is basically an air gap transformer without any core. The PCB is just a simple layer copper plated, which I have used a marker to make the schematic on it, and after using my Dremel to separate the tracks on the PCB. I know it doesn't look pretty, but in the future I will be trying to make it more better. The capacitor C1 has to be very large as possible, and for that I choose this 50 volts and around 6800 microfarads. The red LED will be used at the junction between the gate of our N-channel MOSFETs. The MOSFETs are the 2N3055, and for greater power I have put two of them in parallel. So this has a big advantage, cause it will be helping the circuit dissipating less heat and as well providing the same power or more. Now after setting the bench power supply to around 15 volts, let's connect the power to the Tesla. And you can see a small purple arc which is creating by the Tesla coil by ionizing the air around it. As usually, this Tesla coil can be powering halogen lamps of any type by exciting the phosphor in the lamp, which in result is coming as a glow. In this case, by using these ordinary CFL lamps, it is an intense white. Even daylight CFL tubes like this one salvaged from an old timer are easily lightened by the Tesla. And if I increase the voltage up to the maximum of my bench power supply, which is around 30 volts, we can see that the arcs are a bit longer, and as well the light become more brighter and it is starting to become a bit warm. This is what we call it wireless power, and this was the reason why it was invented by our beloved Nikola Tesla to be able to transfer wireless energy to our house. Now I'll be taking a step forward by powering the Tesla coil from a supply of around 45 volts. provided by a bigger booster converter I was having around. The bus converter, it will be powered by one of my 12 volts battery, and after setting the voltage to around 45 volts, I have connecting the Tesla coil to it. As you can see, the arcs are more bigger and scary, but as well quite fascinating to look at them. Now at this voltage, the Tesla coil can provide more power as seeing here. If you are looking for a crude MP gun, this is what you'll need, because this Tesla coil, it will interfere with nearby electronics. As an example, here I have my small 2x10 watt studio LED, and as you can see, because the power of the LED passed through a relay, it will get affected by it. Just have a listen for the fan. And as well to the sensible equipment like this DVM or digital voltmeter, you can see that if it will come nearby, it will start to work like crazy. I hope you have learned something interesting today, and if that is the case, don't forget to check my other videos. This was a fun project to make, and as well, this Tesla coil showed that it can be further beefed up, but this is a subject for another video. So until then, have a nice day, and thank you very much for watching. See ya!